I'm Dihong March Tower, the founder of SpaWiz, a coaching company help you to grow your business. I have been thinking of doing YouTube video for a while. I'm so glad I'm doing it eventually. And today, first I'd like to talk about a little bit about my background. I was an English teacher in China for several years. After I came to the US in 2004, I attended a Judah Pacific University and achieved a bachelor's degree. After that, I worked at a preschool for several years and then advanced to a site supervisor position. Then me and my husband had a thrift store business. And after that, we bought three spas. And in August 2017, we sold our spas because my husband's job relocation. And then after that, I started to write my book. It's called Spa Principles. In this book, I read about spa setup, spa staff management, customer relation, marketing, and finance. Personally, I love to have a massage and I love doing massage and I'm good at doing massage too. I know how important to go into a spa to have a good massage and have a good customer service. And I had a spa and we managed one. It's a very successful one. So I like to talk about how to run a successful spa. Today I'd like to talk about the front desk, how important the front desk is. And first, when you enter a spa, it's the first person you encounter is the front desk. So the front desk is the image of your company, your spa. And so first you will see, if you see a front desk dress up, you know, you have the spa uniform on and smile first. This is the most important thing. The front desk will smile and sweetly and introduce herself. Say, "Hi, I'm Judy. How can I help you today?" And so for front desk, that's the first impression. You smile, you're sweet. You introduce yourself. And don't discriminate other people, depends on who enter the spa. If somebody you think will have a massage with you guys, it's good. But you can judge, you can tell some people are not here for the massage, or somebody just come in and want to use a bathroom, you still treat them nicely. There shouldn't be no discrimination. You don't look down on anybody and discriminate or make them feel you don't pay attention to them. You treat everybody the same, okay? And if you can say, you know, the bathroom in the back, yes, of course, let them use your bathroom. Or, you know, if the person come in to sell something, and you treat them nicely too, okay? You don't know who is going to be your customer down the road. If they don't have a massage today, they may have a massage, have a service another day, and they will also recommend your business to the people they know. They will say, "Hey, you know, such a day I entered the spa to use the restroom, and the front desk is so nice, and you should go try to have a massage there." It's word by mouth, you never know, okay? Everybody can be somebody, right? And then the next thing is, if the customer wants a massage, you give the customer the option based on the menu, and the kind of massage you offer depends, different price, different time. And then you ask customer, "What do you want to accomplish today? And what's your main concern? Do you have any pain on your shoulder, your neck, your arm?" You say, you know, if you have a lot of pain on your neck and shoulder, why don't you... Also, if you say you have pain on your... You want to do some your foot massage, right? If the customer say yes, you say, you know, why don't you try the combination massage? For let's say $15, $10 extra, you get more time on your back, on your body, and also will help you with your foot too. And so just give customers different options. And you also you let the customer talk. Try let customer give the customer the stage, let them talk. And the customers will open up, say, you know, I just had a 8 hours hiking this morning. Oh, yesterday I'm really exhausted. I need a lot of help. In that case, you know, you can recommend the customer say, I don't think the 1 hour massage is enough for you. You know, I think why don't you try the 90 minutes massage? In that case, you will have more time on your body for $15 extra. You get 30 more minutes massage. You say, you know, trust me, for your situation, you really need 90 minutes. Or just keep in your mind, it's up to you. If you just want to stick to the 1 hour, that's fine. But if you like, you want more time, you can have it and let me know. So you give the customer the option to choose. And just say, you know, trust me, you will love it. You just try to help the customer to decide. You're not convincing the customer to buy, and don't be pushy, and don't just say do it and buy it. Don't let customer feel that way. Give them the final saying to decide. And then when the masseuse come out, if the masseuse doesn't speak fluent English, it's the front desk's job to communicate with the masseuse and tell the therapist what the customer want. Was where to more focus on, where to avoid, and the kind of pressure the customer want. And then during the service, it's very important. Your job as front desk is not done. It's not done. Just you get a customer and you think your job is done. It's not finished. Not finished there. So during the massage, during the service, It's good once in a while you go into the massage room, or if you can, if the door's not locked, or some places they have curtain. So you just, go back and forth, make sure the customers know for the question, or the masseuse, sometimes they forget to add hostel, they forget where to focus on, or sometimes they forget the time. They think it's 1 hour, but actually it's 90 minutes. But when you're passing by, they will just ask, hey, is it 90 minutes? You say, yes, it's 90 minutes. So to kind of avoid a lot of miscommunication and to further fulfill the customer's need. And then after the massage, the customer come out, it's very important you ask the customer about the feedback. Hey, how did you like the massage? How's everything? And if the customer like the massage, is great. If not, they will say, hey, you know what, the pressure is too soft. You can say, you just ask the customer, did you ask him to go hard? And you say, next time, and we have if you don't like the massage, we have 15 minutes policy, we can change somebody else for you. Next time, just remember and keep this in mind, but I want you to have the best, to get the best massage, the best service. You deserve it. You spend time and money here. I want you to have the best. But always encourage the customer to speak out and just make them feel good, okay? Because sometimes some customers don't want to be offended, don't want to hurt the masseuse's feeling if they speak out. So they just bear it, just finish it, but they come out not happy. But you encourage them to speak out, okay? And then if the customer like the massage, you write down the name of the masseuse, and so next time they can call the masseuse to book him. And also, it's a good idea always recommend other good masseuse. Say, hey, you know, this is David. I'm glad you like David's massage, but why don't you also try Tony, try Sophia next time? They are great too. Okay, just write their names on the back of the card wherever you can. And so the customer have backup and just say, and they believe you and just build relationship too. And then if there are things you also can do to build a relationship. If the customer is waiting for Uber to pick her up and sitting down there, and it's your time to utilize this time to build a relationship, just ask customer, you know, hey, the weather's good, how it's so nice outside, are you local, are you from here? If the customer say, no, I'm from Australia, you say, oh my god, great, I wish I can go there, you know, it's a great country, a lot of animals, but have you ever tried, have you ever visited Hollywood, or have you been to some Korean barbecue places? I know some great barbecue places, it's great, you know, you just go on Yelp and type into Korean barbecue restaurants. You get address and that customer take picture. They have that. They love that. You just go about and beyond and talk to them, build a relationship with them, and leave a good impression. And like you have a happy customer there. And then the customer will tell their friends and relatives, you know, I'll come to your spa. This is how important the front desk is. And if you have any question, you want to talk to me, to leave your feedback, we'll talk more. Thank you.